Hey there, welcome to Flutter Mentor. In this video, I'm going to explain what are widget properties. This video is meant for absolute Flutter beginners. This will help you to understand how Flutter actually works, because in the beginning, it can be confusing sometimes. So let's get to it. So before I explain to you what exactly are widget properties, I'm going to begin by explaining the logic behind Flutter. Basically, when you create an app, you have two sides of the app, which is the logic of the app or the backend. Anything related to what isn't shown to the user on the screen is one of the sides, and the other side is what the user sees. Let's just divide it like that. And over here, what you need to understand is that logical part, or the part that doesn't show to the user, is meant to come right here before you override the build method. And that's exactly what's happening right here. We created a class called home that extends stateless widget, and it could be a stateful widget as well. If you use control plus click on Windows or command plus click on a Mac, that will take you to the original file of whatever you clicked on. Now, if you're a beginner, this will be way too complicated to you, but the green words are comments that are meant to help you understand what is going on here. But as you can see, this is what's up, the build method. The build method that you have right here comes from this class right here, and it can also come from a stateful widget class. They both have it. And the build method essentially will return everything that will show up on screen. So before the build method is everything that is logical, and what is returned by the build method is everything that will show up on screen. And you can also have some logic before you return, but it's usually left over here because anything that is within this method will be called every time the build method is called, and that is called every time a rebuild is necessary, which ends up being quite a few times. So you'll mostly work on this end when it comes to logical things. Very rarely you will place something here, and everything you Y related will be right here. So what is a widget? Very basically, a widget is like a blueprint. Everything in Flutter is a widget, essentially. Even the app itself is a widget. Widgets are just how Flutter works, and Flutter's goal is to make creating apps a simpler and faster process. Widgets are basically classes. If I do control click again, it's a class, and it's even also extending a stateful widget. So a widget is a class, and the reason widgets exist is to make your life easier. A scaffold is essentially, like the word says, it's the structure of what you're going to see on the screen. So imagine you're just working with Dart and Flutter doesn't exist. If you want to create a scaffold, you're pretty much gonna have to write a bunch of code. Maybe not as much code as you can see right here, but it would be a lot of code anyway. But instead, it's already pre-made and ready for you to use it. But apps are extremely customized. You can make a class for all apps. So since widgets are basically blueprints and they need to be customizable, that's exactly where properties come in. Now, this is a scaffold widget, and if you use control plus spacebar or command plus spacebar on Mac, you get a list of all the available properties to use. And these properties are exactly how you configure each widget to serve its function specifically for what you want. Because some people are going to want a scaffold that has a black background color, some people will want a scaffold that has a red background color, etc. The key to Flutter is to know exactly the widgets that you need to use, and then knowing how to use the widget. And you know that via the properties that the widget has. And you could also click here and use Control Q, and it will also tell you the properties like this. But I find it simpler to look at them like this. For example, the first thing you need to do is an app bar. So you select the app bar property, and then you just use the app bar widget. And once again, if you wanted to do an app bar without Flutter, you would have to do something like this, pretty much. Which, once again, as you can see, is a lot of code. So thank you, Flutter, for this. And now that we've placed the app bar widget within the scaffold's property, we can also customize the app bar widget itself. Once again, control spacebar, and you get a list of all the different properties that you can use to customize the app bar to your preference. For example, let's give it a title. Now I'm going to press control S to save this, and it will hot reload, and there it is. And here's a great example. Some people will want the title to be on the left side, but some people will want to center the app bar title. And in this case, the app bar class, once again, control space, has a property called center title. And as you can see right here, it says bool. That means the type that the property is expecting. And you can also use control plus Q, and it will tell you right here, type bool. That's what the property expects you to input there. Just like here in app bar, it said preferred size widget app bar. And if you use control Q on app bar, it will tell you the type of the app bar. And app bar is a preferred size widget type. If you click it and then you search for preferred size, you will see that the class app bar, not only is it extending a stateful widget, but it also implements preferred size widget. And then if you go to title, it tells you it expects a widget. So it didn't have to be a text widget, it could be any kind of widget, as long as it will look good, it will be a good decision. But usually here, people use the text widget because the title is usually letters. But coming back to center title, it expects a bool. So you either put in false or true, but false is already the default case. So we're putting in true so that the title can be centered, like so. And now I'm going to click right here at the end of the app bar. I'm going to press enter. Once again, I'm going to use control space, and here is the list of properties, and the one that I want is the body property. And if you don't know what a property does, you can use control Q and it will tell you right here. For example, this is the primary content of the scaffold, which means everything you want to do starts right here. And I'm going to give you an example of a widget that doesn't really show on the UI, which is the center widget. If I say this, everything remains the same. But this widget, it's one of the widgets that help control where things go. And once again, if you wanted to do it on your own, here is the amount of code that you would need to do. And all widgets have properties because all widgets are customizable, at least to a certain extent. For example, the center widget only has 4 different properties. And in this case, we want to use the child because we want to show something being represented in the UI. Let's use a text widget. And even the text widget has many different properties. But in the text widget's case, if you press control space, it might confuse you because the list of properties doesn't show up. But that's because the first property, or in this case argument, is positional. It's not named. And what do I mean by this? If I click on the class right here, you will see that first it expects data, and only then it has the properties. This is a positional argument, and the remainder are named arguments, because properties are essentially arguments of a class's constructor. So in this case, you would have to put in the data. It expects a string, just like it says right here. A non-null string must be provided to a text widget, Flutter Mentor. Now that that's done, if you use the comma and then use control plus space, then you get the list of properties, or arguments. Just like I use up here, I use the style property to make the text white. Text style is the widget that the style property expects. Once again, control plus Q, and it says right here text style. And of course, as you already know, text style itself has its own properties. Let's change, for example, the font size. And it says right here it expects a double. And a double is pretty much just a number that ends in a decimal instead of being a whole number, which is an int. And I'm going to save it now, and you're going to see that it's perfectly centered, and it says exactly what we input there, Flutter Mentor. And you can come here and do another comma and change the color to colors.deeporange. And that's pretty much what the widget properties are. They are just ways to configure any widget to be more like you need it to be. And that's what makes Flutter great. There's a lot of work done already for you, and Flutter is extremely customized, making it perfect to create apps at a faster pace and with a little less headaches. And just to show you how it would look like without the center widget, I'm going to press Alt plus Enter, and then I'm going to select remove this widget. And if I save it, Flutter Mentor is no longer perfectly centered on the screen. So start practicing now. Use as many widgets as you can. Use as many properties as you can. Just try it out. Figure it out. Experience will be your best friend with this. And if you want to master Flutter, subscribe to this channel, drop a like, and I will see you on the next lesson. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.